President of the General Assembly, Excellencies, Heads of States and Government, Secretary General of the United Nations, ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to participate at this important event on addressing the financing needs for sustainable development in the era of COVID-19 and beyond. I thank the governments of Canada and Jamaica and the Secretary General of the United Nations for the initiative. I also thank the co-leads of the six discussion groups for their leadership. Excellencies, the COVID-19 pandemic has severely disrupted our societies and economies, worsened inequalities, and deepened the gap between available resources and the resources needed to finance the Sustainable Development Goals. We must mobilize finance in response to this pandemic-induced economic crisis and also for long-term development. As co-lead with Barbados on illicit financial flows, Nigeria wishes to stress that illicit financial flows have continued to erode domestic revenues, undermine governance, threaten economic stability, and diminish the abilities of governments to provide much-needed public services. To overcome these challenges, we must combat illicit financial flows with all the determination we can muster. We must act swiftly to adopt measures to ensure that taxes are paid where value is created, and this is especially important for the digital economy. We must also establish public beneficial ownership registers and strengthen arrangements for the exchange of tax information. Similar priority should also be given to tackling money laundering and corruption. Indeed, given the challenges that my country has faced in its efforts to repatriate illicitly acquired assets, we endorse the recommendation for spontaneous disclosure and the enhancement of legal frameworks for conviction-based asset forfeitures. It's important to stress that the main destinations for illicit financial flows must support the efforts to stop this scourge and work with the global community to dismantle the architecture that supports illicit financial flows, such as financial secrecy jurisdictions. Excellencies, in addition, we support the call for debt relief for developing countries and the extension of the debt suspension initiative until 2021, as well as the granting of commercial debt relief where needed. We also call for enhanced global liquidity, including through the allocation of unused special drawing rights currently held by developed countries. The increased flow of remittances can support development financing needs, so it's important to reduce the cost of making such transfers. As global leaders, we must do everything in our power to emerge from the crisis caused by the COVID-19 by striving together in order to deliver for all. Thank you very much.